Hello everyone, welcome to QAFox.com. This is Arun Motori. In this Selenium automation tutorial series, I am going to continue with the topic CSS selector locators. As part of this topic, I've already covered 10 parts in the previous videos. In the current video session, I am going to cover the 11th part of CSS selector locators topic, that is using comma and asterisk symbols in CSS selectors. So how to use comma and asterisk symbols in CSS selectors will be explained in this current video session. So guys, let's get started. So guys, these are all the different examples that I am going to practically demonstrate for explaining how to use asterisk and this comma symbols in CSS selectors. So let's switch to the practical mode now. Open this sample application, that is omaya.blogspot.com, in this Chrome browser. As you can see, there are different elements displayed on this page which you can use for practice purpose. So right click somewhere on this page where this is no UI element and select this inspect option. Okay, so the Chrome developer options will be displayed as shown below. So by default, elements tab will be selected, and as you can see, under the elements tab, the complete HTML code of this entire page, okay, will be displayed. Fine. So entire HTML code will be displayed like this, guys. You can expand and see how the different tags under each and every tag here. Okay. So now, guys, let me start explaining this examples practically. First thing is about using comma. Okay. How to use comma symbol in CSS selectors. Before directly going there, guys, I would like to do few things. That is, so while the elements tab is selected, select this pro path and select this CSS selector option from the drop down. Now, the first thing is, let's locate this text area field. Okay, right click on this text area field and select inspect option. The HTML code for this text area field will be displayed like this. Using this HTML code, let's create a CSS selector for locating this text area field. So as you can see, in the HTML code of this text area field, the tag name is text area. So type here text area. Open the square bracket. It has some unique ID, guys. Give ID as TA1. Okay, the value. ID, attribute name, and value. Just give it like this and press enter. Using this CSS selector, we can locate the text area field, right? So using this locator, we are able to locate the text area field. Now let's try to locate this button. Okay, right click on this button, select inspect option. Okay, as you can see, the HTML code for this button is displayed here. So using this HTML code, we'll create CSS selector for locating this button. Okay, so this is the button. So it has some button tag. So type button here and open the square bracket. It has some ID, unique ID and value. So give ID is equal to value and then close the square bracket and press enter. Observe that this button is getting located using this CSS selector. Copy this and paste it somewhere. Now guys, at a time, I want to locate both this text area field and the button. Okay, this is a CSS selector for locating the text area field. This is a CSS selector for locating the button. Okay, so put a comma and place the two CSS selectors, one on the left side of the comma and one on the right side of the comma, like this, guys. Okay, just separate these two CSS selectors with a comma symbol like this. Okay, copy this entire statement and paste it here and press enter. What's happening, guys? By using this comma, okay, you can use multiple CSS selectors in a single CSS selector statement. Okay, in a single selector statement itself, you can use multiple CSS selector statements just by separating them using comma. This comma will act as an OR symbol, guys. Okay, this one or this one, since both are working. Okay, since both are in working condition, what happened using this CSS selector, guys, which CSS selectors which are separated by comma, both the UI elements got located. This first CSS selector, okay, you see two elements are matching. The first CSS selector is locating the text area field and the second CSS selector, which is after the comma, is locating the button. So using the single CSS selector, we are able to locate multiple UI elements on the page like this, guys. We can use comma in case of this or this, but in real time, guys, this may not be the purpose. Okay, in real time, this may not be the purpose. You don't have to locate multiple UI elements just by providing comma between multiple CSS letters. That may not be the real time case. In real time, so there is a chance like you may get some your application may be on different staging environments or okay, so your application may be different in different environments, okay, different staging environments, production environment, like that. So while you are executing your automation scripts, okay, in one environment it may not working on another environment, guys. Okay, the locator for example, this button is there, and but you will be testing your application in multiple staging environment, staging environment 1 and staging environment 2, let's say. Okay, in the same staging environment 1, the button is there, but it has a different ID. And coming to the staging environment 2, where you have the same application and the same button, but the ID value for that button is different in the HTML code. There may be some cases, guys. This kind of cases you may get in real time. It's not compulsory, but if you get such kind of cases, guys, okay, you can actually create multiple selectors, okay, for one button in the staging one environment, for the same button in the staging two environment, because you need to create multiple locators there. Okay, and for staging environment one, same button, you have to create one CSS selector. For staging two, staging environment two, same button, you have to create another CSS locator. So at a time only one locator will work, right? That's where we can give this comma symbol. So if it is staging environment one, this part which comes on the left side of the comma will work. Otherwise, this part which will come after the on the right side of the comma will work. Like that, guys. This is a real time case I explained. Okay, but the main purpose of comma is to or operator. Okay, so if both are working, it will locate this kind of situation will come. Okay, where if the elements are different, it will locate two elements. Okay, so it's an or operator kind of thing, guys. Using comma in CSS selector is like using or operator, where this one or this one, or okay, or both. Fine. Now we are done with the comma, using comma symbol in CSS selectors, guys. Let's move to the next symbol, that is using asterisk. Okay, asterisk symbol. How to use asterisk symbol? For example, guys, if you want to locate all the elements on this web page, what you will do? I want to locate all the each and every, okay, even I don't want to leave a label or text. Okay, I want to look at all the elements on this web page. Simple, guys. Since different elements on this page have different tags, okay, for example, if you want to look at all the input tags on this page, you will say input. It will locate all the elements on this page having the input tag. If you want to look at all the elements on this page which have anchor tags, that is mostly hyperlinks, okay, so you will look, only hyperlinks will get displayed like this, okay, which have anchor tag in their HTML code. But if you want to locate all the elements irrespective of whether they are input tags or anchor tags, okay, in that case you have to provide a symbol known as asterisk. Here asterisk means any tag, okay, and press enter, guys. So you see all the elements got located, guys. All the elements, there are around 893 elements are matching on this particular page, okay, so all the elements will be located like this. Now let's go to the next example. Locate all the immediate child tags under the head tag, okay. So first let locate the head tag, guys. So only one element will be matching, that is this head tag, okay. So let's locate all the child tags. All the child tags, few of the child tags are having the link tag name, few other child tags are having meta tag name, okay, some are having the title, some are having the style, like that, non script, lot of things are there, lot of different types of tags are under this head tag. So if you want to locate, okay, immediate childs of this head tag, okay, if you want to locate only the link tags, you simply press link, guys. Okay, so there are seven tags, child tags under this head tag which are having the link tag, okay, but if you want to locate any type of tag, any type of child tag under this head tag, you just need to provide the asterisk symbol, guys. Okay, asterisk here means any tag. So here this is a symbol for parent and child, right? So parent and child can have this symbol in between, otherwise it cannot have. So here head is a parent of this children. So child tags can have any type of tags. So press enter, guys. 20 elements are matching. That is, the link here is CSS1, meta is CSS2, like that. Meta CSS3, meta CSS4. Okay, here link is 5. Again, link is 6. Another link 7, link 8, link 9. Okay, again meta 10, another meta 11, another meta 12, title 13, style 14, another style 15. Non-script 17, like that, each and every tag, okay, completely there are around 20, guys, 20 tags, 20 child tags under this head tag. you want to locate all the child tags, you have to use the asterisk symbol. Okay. Next thing is locate all the immediate child tags under the body tag. Okay. Similar to under head, we have this many number of, right? Under body also, we want to locate all the immediate child tags. I don't want to locate the grandchild tags. Okay. Under div, again, div is there. This will not, I don't want this div to be located. I want to locate immediate child. Okay. This div is the immediate child of this body. Again, this div is another child of the body. Okay. I don't want to, this meta is a grandchild because it has a parent div and this parent is a child of body. I don't want meta to be discovered. I only want the immediate children of this body tag to be discovered. So first locate the body greater than immediate children. It can be any tag, guys. It can be div tag, it can be script tag like that. So for that reason, we can provide asterisk. Asterisk means any tag. Press enter. How many are there? 7. So this first div, CSS is called 1. This internal div will not be located, guys. You see, there is no CSS to here. Okay. Only the immediate children will be located, not grandchildren. Second div, CSS is equal to 2. Third div, CSS is equal to 3. Fourth div, CSS is equal to 4. Script, CSS is equal to 5. Another script, CSS is equal to 6. Another script, 7. Okay. So how many are there? 7 child tags are there under the body tag. All those things got located. Now, locate all the immediate child tags, and at same time, you want to locate all the grandchildren also. Okay. So here only we are locating only the immediate child tags, guys. But if you want to locate child and grandchildren, remove this, replace this greater than symbol with space, guys. Okay. This space means this body tag can become a parent tag or a grandparent tag of the any tag under it. So press enter. How many came? 858. There are many, guys. Okay. So under div tag, CSS is equal to 1 is there. Inside this div tag, there may be another grandchild tag of this body tag, that is CSS is equal to 2. Okay. Again, if you expand, another script tag is there. CSS is equal to 3. Script tag CSS is equal to 4. So child and grandchild tags of this body tag. Okay. If you place HTML here and press enter, it will be, the count will be more, guys. 892. Okay. Even HTML under that head body will be counted. Under head, the grandchild, their child, all the ancestors and grandchildren of this HTML will be located, children and grandchildren. Okay. So like that, guys, you can play with this comma and asterisk symbols and CSS selectors like this. These are all the different examples for demonstrating how to use comma and asterisk symbols in CSS selectors. So we are done with the examples, guys. Practical demonstrations we are done with. Let's switch to the presentation mode now. So all the examples for demonstrating on how to use comma and asterisk symbols in CSS selectors are already practically demonstrated. So here ends this current video session, guys. In the next video session, I will explain using other symbols like starts with, ends with, contains. Okay. Each and everything like starts with has a separate symbol to use in CSS selectors. Ends with have other symbol for using in CSS selectors. Okay. Here starts is like cap, ends with is like dollar symbol. Contains is like asterisk symbol, guys. We have to use these different symbols in CSS selectors. So how to use them and what is the purpose of using them? Okay, all those things will be explained in the next video session. So that's it, guys. See you in the next session. Thank you. Bye.